Next surah is Surah At-Teen. Teen means fig, the fruit. Let's read the surah first. والتين والزيتون وطور سينين وهذا البلد الأمين لقد خلقنا الإنسان في أحسن تقويم ثم رددناه أسفل سافلين إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات فلهم أجر غير ممنون فما يكذبك بعد بالدين أليس الله بأحكم الحاكمين. In this surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, first of all, swears of four things. Number one is teen, number two is zaytun, and number three, watur is sinin, and number four, wahadha al-baladul amin. We know that teen, the fig, and zaytun, which is we know as zaytun, or the translation of the word zaytun is olive. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is swearing, taking the oath of these two special fruits, which give a lot of benefits in our life. Because of being special, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala swears. Some Fasreen have said that teen, there is no bone inside the teen fruit, fig. In the fig there is no bone. And it resembles the fruit of the Jannah. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala swears by this fruit. Wat-teeni wa-zaytun. And zaytun is also a fruit that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us. There are many benefits that we can get through zaytun. When you eat it and when you use the oil of the zaytun, the oil of olive oil for your body, for your inner self, or for anything. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put barakah in these two fruits. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is swearing, is taking the oath of these two fruits. وطور سينين, the third thing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is swearing by is the mountain on which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talked to Musa alayhi salatu wa salam. Tur in Arabic means the mount, and Sinin is the name of that mountain on which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talked to Musa alayhi salatu wa salam. Sinin or Sayna, Tur Sayna atambutu bidduhni wa sibghin lil akilin. In other words, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions that Sinin or Sayna is the name of that area where this tur, this mount, is located. Or Sinin in other meanings means very beautiful. Or Mufassirin also have mentioned some other meanings, that Sinin also means a tur, a mount which has a lot of fruit. Fruit trees, like which has a lot of trees, and especially fruit trees, that is called Tur Sinin. Or it means the barakah, that this mount is the mount of barakah. That is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is swearing this. However, because of being special, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is swearing Tur Sinin. وَهَذَا الْبَلَدِ الْأَمِينَ, and by the city of security. Al-Baladul Amin, here refers to Al-Makkatul Mukarrama, which is Al-Baladul Amin. Al-Amin is from Amana, or it is from Aman, means peace. Whoever goes there to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Makkatul Mukarrama, he becomes secure and he's safe, he's protected there. So it is called Al-Baladul Amin. It is the city which gives aman to everybody, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala swears by this city. After this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the thing which he wants, that we have created man in the best shape, in the best form, in the best of mold. You see at human beings that how beautiful Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created him. How beautifully Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fashioned him. You look at every single part of his body and you will see that how beautiful he is. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him brain, heart. He could think what is and understand what is wrong, what is right, what is good for him, what is bad for him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made him mu'tadil, moderate in his shape. لَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي أَحْسَنِ تَقْوِيمٍ ثُمَّ رَدَدْنَاهُ أَسْفَلَ سَافِلِينَ. In this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned what he, that how he reduced, says, human beings to the lowest of the low. It has two meanings. Number one, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala creates human beings. They are born, then they become kids, then they are adults, they have strength, power in themselves, they are talented, they have skills, they can do a lot of things in their life. And after they grow older, you see that they stop working or they become slow in working. Now they may not use their brain as they used to do in their adulthood. They may not move their hands, their fingers, their feet as they used to do when they were adults. ثُمَّ رَدَدْنَاهُ أَسْفَلَ سَافِلِينَ. Thus that we reduced him to the lowest of the low, that he becomes in a way that he is motionless, he can't do anything. And there is a time you have breath in your side, the soul is still in your body, but you cannot see anything, you become blind. You cannot hear, you cannot recognize people, you cannot feel the taste of things. This is ثُمَّ رَدَدْنَاهُ أَسْفَلَ سَافِلِينَ. We made, reduced him to the lowest of the low. This is one meaning. The other meaning is that when people worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they understand his commands and his orders, they follow them, they apply them in their life, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created them in the best forms, that they are human beings, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has elevated their status. They are honored or honorable creatures among all the creatures. But when they disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they turn away from the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reduces them to the lowest of the low, that they become the most hated people or the most hated creatures among other creatures. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroys them sometimes or will punish them in the hereafter. So they become the lowest of the low. But there are exceptions, that there might be some people who believe in Allah and who do good deeds, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saves them from them. But Allah protects them. When punishment comes to people, Allah takes care of those people and this punishment does not affect them. And these are the people who believe in Allah. And with the belief, they also do good deeds. They perform righteous deeds in this worldly life. And for them will be a good ajr, good reward in the hereafter. That reward will be very huge, and that is in the form of Jannah. At the end of the surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking a question, that what happened to these disbelievers? They don't believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and also they don't believe in the day of resurrection. They deny the day of recompense, that they will be compensated on the day of resurrection. They disbelieve in that. What happened to them? Do not they see at their own self how beautiful we have created them, and it is in our hands, that if they disbelieve in that, we will make them to the lowest of the low. So they should not deny Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they should not deny the day of resurrection. They must turn in repentance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَمَا يُكَذِّبُكَ بَعْدُ بِالدِّينِ. And Allah says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the best of the judges. He judges, he will judge things in the hereafter. He will call all the people, they will be in front of him. Whoever has done good deeds, he will be rewarded according to that. And whoever has done best deeds, good deeds, he will be rewarded according to his deeds. وَالتِّينِ وَالزَّيْتُونِ by the fig and the olive. وَطُورِ سِينِينَ by Mount Sinin. وَهَذَا الْبَلَدِ الْأَمِينِ by this city of security. This is Mecca. لَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي أَحْسَنِ تَقْوِيمِ verily we created man in the best form. ثُمَّ رَدَدْنَاهُ أَسْفَلَ سَافِلِينَ then we reduced him to the lowest of the low. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ فَلَهُمْ أَجْرٌ غَيْرُ مَمْنُونَ save those who believe in Islam, in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in his prophet, and do righteous deeds. فَلَهُمْ أَجْرٌ غَيْرُ مَمْنُونَ then they shall have a reward without end, and that is paradise. فَمَا يُكَذِّبُكَ بَعْدُ بِالدِّينِ then what or who causes you, O disbelievers, to deny the recompense, to deny the day of resurrection. أَلَيْسَ اللَّهُ بِأَحْكَمِ الْحَاكِمِينَ is not Allah the best of the judges? This is the end of Surah At-Tin. Inshallah, next week we will start Surah Al-Alaq.